Hello everyone. So if you're seeing this error excluded by Nodex tag on your Google Search Console account, then you're not alone. So many people face the same issue. And you can see I'm facing the same issue on my website. I got 17 pages which are showing this problem excluded by Nodex tag. Which means 17 pages on my website are not indexed on Google. Because the reason was they have Nodex tag on these pages. So today I'm going to show you how you can fix this issue on your Google Search Console account. Before we go to the issue directly, let me show you some important things which you need to consider so that you can fix this issue on any kind of website. If I scroll the page here, you can see here all known pages. So we have 48 pages here which are not indexed. But if I scroll the page here, this is 17 pages. Because among these 48 pages, only 17 pages are not indexed because of the no index tag issue. And rest of the pages, they have different issues. That's why they are not indexed in Google search engine. In your case, it can be different number. You have more pages with the issue where it says page with redirect and less number of pages when it's excluded by Nodex tag. If you just scroll the page back and here we can see it says all known pages, which means all known pages to Google. If I click on this drop down, you can see all submitted pages. If I click on all submitted pages, you can see only 14 pages are not indexed. And if I go here and you can see I cannot see anymore the error of no index. But if I click here and I click on unsubmitted pages only, then the error is back which say excluded by no index tag. So what does that mean? So if we go here and check this thing, you see all known pages, which means all the pages Google knows about. And here all submitted pages. So if I use this option, I will see the pages which I submitted to Google through my sitemap. And then unsubmitted pages which I haven't submitted but Google knows about them. I hope you understand that these pages are not always which we submitted on the website. It's really interesting when you see these pages and you'll say you have no idea these pages exist on your website. Okay, I hope you get the background of this issue. Let's go to fixing of this issue. So if I click on excluded by noindex tag, you can see we have 17 pages affected by this issue. If I scroll the page, we have different kind of URLs here. In your case, you will have different URLs here. Okay, now this is really interesting and important to understand. All the pages which are excluded by noindex tag are not necessarily should be shown to Google. Because some pages we want to show to Google, but they are marked by noindex tag. But some pages we don't want to add to Google because we don't want them to be indexed. And Google will just only keep them on their database and that will serve no purpose for us. That will make only our Google Search Console account complicated. Okay, so we'll fix this error in two steps. First step, we're gonna index the pages which you want to index. And the second step will be, we want to remove the pages which you don't want to index. Let me give a very easy example. You can see this page here, which says WordPress versus other website builder. This is a page on website and I want this to be indexed. But it is not indexed because of the no index tag error. Same thing again. How to start a free affiliate blog using Blogger. I want this page to be indexed, but it is not indexed because of this error. But if you see the other URLs, these ones, you can see this is a feed URL. I don't want this URL to be indexed on Google. Same here, you can see a lot of more feed URLs here. Then this email protection URL. And if I go to the next page, you can see we have this page, wplogin.php, actually it's equal to lost password. wplogin.php, you can have different kind of pages here in your Google Search Console report. So all these pages, feed pages and these pages we don't want to show on our website. We'll talk a little bit later about feed pages, but first let's talk about these pages which you want to show on Google and they're not indexed because of no index tag. Okay, so if I click on this arrow here, the page will open which is no index on Google. So what happened now, because of some reason this page is not indexing, and the reason is very simple. To test it by yourself, so now what we'll do, we'll right click here and then click on view page source. So you can see here meta name robots content no index. So what happened when Google will visit any page on our website and Google find this tag no index, Google will not list that page into search engine. And when it happened to a page we want to be indexed on Google, that really hurt our website rankings because that is the content we created to be appear on Google. So in that case, what you can do, if it's very few pages on your website which is having this error, what you can do, you can go to the page or blog post, click on edit post, or you can say edit page. And now depending on which SEO plugin you're using, for example, I'm using Yoast SEO plugin, same method for all-in-one WP SEO plugin or Rank Math is the same procedure. You just need to find this option. If I scroll the page, if I click on advanced, you can see allow search engine to show this post in search result. It is by default set to no. I don't know why it happened. It can be different reason on your website too, but maybe some pages are set to no. So the pages you want to show will set here yes. And then we'll click on update. It's the same procedure. In case of Rank Math or other SEO plugins, you will also find this option on the edit page to allow search engine to show this post in search result. Sometimes you can choose no index or index. So if you see option check no index, you can choose it to index. And now if I refresh the page here, you can see no index. If I refresh the page, you will see it says index. So now when Google will see this page, it will index this page in search engine results. So once you have done that, you can click on this inspect URL. And now you can see it says URL is not on Google, which is very normal because Google might take some days or weeks to index that page. To make the process fast, what we can do now, we can click here on request indexing. It will take some time to test if URL can be indexed. Because we changed no index to index, now Google will have no problem to index this page. And once you click here request indexing, the page will be indexed in Google. It might take some time, so be patient for a few days or few weeks. In your case, if you see hundreds of errors and all your pages which need to be indexed on Google are showing here and they say excluded by no index tag. In that case, you might be blocking the robots.txt file to index all the posts and pages on your website. What do you need to do in that case? You need to log into WordPress dashboard and then scroll the page. Go to settings and click on reading. And now you check here if this option is checked or not. Keep this option unchecked like this one, guys. If you check this option, it will block Google and other search engine to index any of your website pages into the search results. So first make sure this option is unchecked. If you're using a plugin like Rank Math SEO, go to Rank Math SEO and then go to titles and meta. And now from here, make sure this is indexed. If you set up here no index, your pages will not be listed because we are saying Google do not index pages from my website. In case you are using Yoast SEO plugin, you can check one more thing here. Go to content types and then from here, go to pages and then make sure show page in search result is checked. Also, you can check here post also. Show post in search result. And it is really interesting, guys. Sometimes we have different post types on our website. For example, I use Elementor header and footer builder, and this also create a kind of page here. You must be a little bit confused why you are seeing this option here, but what happened when you use different plugins, when we save some data in that, they save like a post type. So make sure this kind of pages then not indexed. You can see it is not indexed, so that's a good thing. So once you make sure everything is good with Yoast SEO, or in case you're using Rank Math SEO, everything good here, you use this option to index. And WordPress setting, search engine visibility is not checked. You can go back to your search engine console, and as I shown you how you fix couple of pages and you fix every pages, what you need to do now is go to sitemap, and now you see the old sitemap of your website which is submitted here. So click on the sitemap and then click on these three dots and click on remove sitemap and click on remove, and now enter your website sitemap URL here. For example, my sitemap URL is my website URL slash sitemap underscore index.xml. In your case, it will be same URL if you're using any of the popular plugins, and click on submit. So now the new sitemap will be submitted and all the URLs which are no index now, they will be indexed. And whenever Google will crawl them again, they will index those pages in search engine results. To find sitemap website, you can enter this URL and then hit enter. If you see sitemap here, that's perfectly good. If you cannot see this page, maybe you are not using a SEO plugin. So I highly recommend you can use a nice plugin like Yoast SEO or Rank Math. I created a video about it. You can watch that video. I'll put the link in the description. Okay, guys, so this was the first part where we fixed this error for the pages we want to show in search engine ranking. Now let's talk about the pages we don't want to show in search engine rankings, but Google is already having those pages in the database. They will not do any harm because they're not indexed. Still, we don't want to make things complicated. Why we want Google keep the data? It makes just Search Console complicated. Let me give some example. So pages like this, feed pages, you can see there's so many feed pages here listed here in the database. They're not indexed on Google, and that's fair enough. I don't want these pages to be indexed on Google. And if I go to second page, you can see here page like wplogin.php or wplogin.php action is equal to lost password. These pages I also don't want to be listed on Google. If I show you example for another website of mine I manage, you can see here there are some URLs, question mark remove item is equal to some number. There are many more page, remove item is equal to some number. If you go to next page, we have the same URL repeated so many times. You can see these more URLs, add to cart is equal to number. You have this other page, question mark S. This is a search page on my website. There's another search result which is added into Google database. It's a good thing it's not indexed, but still added to the Google database. All these pages, how we can remove that? So what you need to do now is, so the page we want to remove from Google database will be search pages or this kind of URLs. And these feed pages. Guys, feed pages is a little bit tricky. Actually, feed is a functionality when some scraper website take the data from a website and then they show in simplest form to some applications. So if you're using an e-commerce website or you have a business website, you don't need feed URLs, honestly. Even in my case, even my blog website, I don't keep feed URLs. But you can leave them. If you have a blog post website, you want to keep them, you can keep them. They will not do any harm. But these other pages, we need to fix them. So for the people who want to fix the feed pages, because a lot of spam comes when you have feed pages on a website. So normally I recommend to most of the people, do not use feed. It doesn't serve any purpose nowadays. Nobody uses the feed reader nowadays. Maybe some people. Comment down below in the video if you are the one who is using a feed readers to access the content from different websites. After deciding everything, you can remove those pages from your website. Normally it is safe to remove those pages. How you can remove these feed pages? First I will tell you how to remove feed pages. Then I will tell you how to remove this kind of other weird pages with the URLs and search pages and different pages. So go to Yoast SEO plugin again and now scroll the page. And then go to crawl optimization. And now scroll page more. And then you will see this option disable unwanted content format. Let me show you this interesting thing how these pages are created. So if I go to a page on my website and same thing I will do, I will right click and go to view page source. If I scroll the page, you will always find this URLs here, application, RSS plus XML. We have three feeds here. You can see the feed, common feed of your website, comments feed, and then the post or page feed. So we don't want these feeds here. And also this will make your website fast because you're reducing the complexity of your website by removing these feed pages. Did not bring huge effect, but yes, every small step is very good to make your website faster and less complicated. So to remove these pages, we'll go to advanced and crawl optimization. Check all this option from here. All of these, check. And once done, we click on save changes. So if I go back to my page source again, if I refresh the page, you can see the feed URLs are gone. In case if you're using Rank Math SEO plugin, there is no direct option to manage these feed pages from the interface here in admin panel. But check this code on your screen. You can add this code on your functions.php file to disable all the feed on your website. I will add this code in the description of this video. So you can copy this code and add to your functions.php file. I will add all the details that how you can add this code on your website functions.php file. So don't worry if you're using Rank Math SEO plugin. Add this code on your functions.php file and your feed URL will be gone. Okay, let's fix second type of pages, which are the URL pages like this. To solve these kind of pages, you need to go back to your SEO plugin. For example, if you're using Yoast SEO plugin, same thing, crawl optimization. So these were the feed pages, we deactivated them. Scroll the page a little bit more and then you'll find this option here a little bit more. Prevent crawling of internal site search URLs. So you can see here, all these URL with the query string, they will be disallowed to access by Google. So enable this option and then click on save changes. But I'll add a solution in the description of the video if you can add a code to your website and remove those kind of pages to be crawled by Google. So now once you solve these things, go back to your Search Console account. And guys, if you see different kind of pattern in your URLs, comment in the video and reply you back to the comment that how you can fix that particular URL. If it's not falling in the categories or kind of pages I explained today. I reply to all the comments on my channel, so don't worry about it. I'm gonna reply you that how you can fix those pages. So once you take action, what I explained in the video, what you need to do is, you'll see this option, exclude by Nodex tag, and then you see validate fix. So click here on validate fix. And when next time Google will process your website sitemap on your website, it will not find these pages. And because they're already not indexed, it will not cause any SEO issue for you if Google don't find those pages anymore because we haven't submitted those pages. Remember, I shown you here this concept, all known pages and submitted pages, because most of those pages will be unsubmitted pages. And guys, most important, wait for a few days or maybe weeks because Google might take some time to relist your website and access all the URLs. If you get some help from this video, don't forget to like the video. Subscribe to my channel. Subscribing is totally free. That really boosts my morale. And guys, make sure you turn on all the notifications because I'm going to create many more videos on Search Console. I'm going to show you how you can solve different kind of errors we see in Google Search Console that will really help you to increase your website traffic. And if you want to watch a video on Yoast SEO plugin to improve your search engine ranking, check out this video on screen. And if you want to know how you can get perfect score for PageSpeed Insight, check this other video on screen.